हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट केमिकल बॉन्डिंग एंड मॉलिक्यूलर स्ट्रक्चर। दिस इज यूनिट 4 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी 2। नाउ यू कैन सी हियर ए अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स। द अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स विच होल्ड्स various constituents, atoms, ions, together in different chemical species is called chemical bonds. So this is the definitions of bonds. Now friends, one theory is Posse-Lewis approach to chemical bonding. This approach is Lewis postulated that atoms achieve the stable octet when they are linked by chemical bonds. Their target is stable octet. Just remember, stable octet in case of hydrogen dude, stable outer octet of electrons. So how you symbolize this? You can see lithium, beryllium, boron and carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. This is very good examples. You just remember the position of electrons. You see the electrons 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So every elements they need like that. So what is the significance of Lewis symbol? Is symbols ka matlab kya hai? What is the importance? So Cossel in relation to chemical bond drew attention to the following facts. There is some facts like in the periodic table the highly electronegative halogens and highly electropositive alkali metals are separated by the noble gases. The formations of negative ion from a halogen atom and the positive ion from an alkali metals atom is associated with the gain and loss of an electron by the respective atom. The negative and positive ions thus form attain a stable noble gas electronic configuration. The noble gases, with the exceptions of helium, which has a doublet of electrons, have particularly a stable outer shell configurations of 8 octet electrons in NH2 NP6. The negative and positive ions are stabilized by electrostatic attractions. Now you can see sodium taken one electrons and remove one electrons in making sodium plus. Here you see calcium loses two electrons and it becomes calcium 2 plus. So the bond formed as a result of the electrostatic attractions between the positive and negative ions was termed as the electrovalent bond. And the electrovalent is thus equal to the number of unit charge on the ions. Now friends, octet rules about the, you see the covalent bond. Langmuir refined the Lewis postulation by abandoning the idea of the stationary cubical arrangement of the octet and introducing the term covalent bonds. So look at here, this chlorine and this chlorine share these two electrons, and this chlorine has 8 electrons, this chlorine has an electron, and like that the dot represent electrons. Such structures are referred to as Lewis dot structure. You can see here the formations of water, the formations of carbon tetrachloride. So when two atoms share one electron pair, they are said to be joined by a single covalent bond. And in many compounds, we have multiple bonds. If two atoms share two pairs of electrons, the covalent bond between them is called double bonds. This is the example where double bond you can see in carbon dioxide, and this is a linear molecule. You can see in C2H4 molecules, hydrogen-hydrogen forming dude. And so when combining atoms share three electrons pair, as in case of two nitrogen atom in N2 molecules and the two carbon atom in the ethylene molecules, a triple bond is formed. You see, this is double bond, this is triple bond. In acetylene, triple bonds. So Lewis representation of simple molecules. The Lewis dot structure provide a picture of bonding in molecules and ions in terms of shared pair of electrons and the octet groups. So friends, now you can see here H2 how O2 arrangement of atom, O3 Lewis dot structure, NF3 carbonate and nitric acid. So friend, formal charge. What is the formal charge? Formal charge on an atom in a Lewis structure is equal to total number of valence electron in the free atoms. Total number of valence electrons in the free atom minus total number of non-bonding lone pair of electrons and minus half total number of bonding shared electrons. This is the formula of formal charge. We called it FC. Now you can see we have the ozone, so three atoms, and you can check with the atom 1, 6 minus 2 minus half into 6 is equal to plus 1 charge. This you can see 6 minus 4 minus half into 4, 0 charge, and this int 6 minus 6 minus half into 2 is equal to minus 1 charge. So this one is positive charge, this one is negative charge. How you can calculate? You just go to total number of valence electron in the free atom. So oxygen have total number of 6 electrons, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. Then total number of valence electron in the free atom minus total number of non-bonding or lone pair of electrons. Here, in case of here, one lone pair of electrons. In case of this, two lone pair of electrons. In case of three lone pair of electrons. So 1, 2, 3 means 6 electrons. Here 2 electrons. Here 4 electrons. And then you have the formula minus half total number of bonding electrons. So here bonding electron, here 6. 1, 2, 3 bonds. So 6 electrons. In case of 2, this is 2 bonds, so 4 electrons, and here is 1 bond, so 2 electrons. So you can easily find out the charge of both. So generally the lowest energy structure is the one with the smallest formal charge on atom. The formal charge is a factor based on pure covalent view of bonding in which electrons pair are shared equally by neighboring atoms. Now friends, what is the limitations of octet rule? You can see here in complete octet of the central atom like BH2, BCl3, odd electrons molecules like this NO, NO2, the expanded octet, example BF6, SF6, NH2SO4. So other drawback of the octet theory that this theory does not account for the shape of the molecule. It does not explain the relative stability of molecules, being totally silent about the energy of a molecule. So friends, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.